Hello friends, this is Yogesh Muramkar. In this video, we are going to talk about aggregate functions, group by clause, and some other functions like how to find out day, date, and time. So this is the statement we are going to talk about. Execute the aggregate functions like count, sum, average, etc. on suitable database and make use of built-in functions to find need of database chosen according to the need of database chosen. And then we are going to use these functions like now, date, and day. So these are the questions which we are going to solve by using this database MySQL. So I am already connected to MySQL database. So let me show you which tables we are going to use. This is the EMP table, which is having 13 rows in it. So let us move the first question to solve. Display today's date and time using built-in functions. So to check what is today's date, we have a function, built-in function, that is now in MySQL. So let's fire this command, select now from dual. Dual is like a scratch pad. It's a table, which is a built-in table, and now is a built-in function. So this is the today's date. Next question, display time, date, and day separately. Okay, so we want to display time, date, and day separately. So what we are going to do is, we are going to use again the built-in functions for time, date, and day. So let us find out, try to find out what is the today's time. So we are going to use a function that is time to find out the time, and then we will show how to find out the date also. So time, and pass it today's date and time. So it is going to fetch you the time. So this is the way to find out the time. After finding out the time by using a built-in function, this is the way to find out the day. And next one is date. So date is also a built-in function available in MySQL database. So this is how you can find out today's date. Then third question, display the average salary of all employees. So we can use the aggregate function called as AVG to find out the average salary of all the employees. So just fire this command. Select AVG of sal from EMP. So this is the average salary. Next question, find the total number of employees. We want to find out the count of total number of employees. So we can use one more aggregate function, that is count. So select count of star. You can make it a star, or you can make it as a count of some column name also. So there are 13 number of employees. So here you can see 13 rows, that means there are 13 number of employees. So I could have done it like this. Select count of ename also from EMP, that should have also worked. Next question is, find the sum. Then for finding out the sum, we use a function called as sum. So sum of salary. So this is the sum of the salary of all the employees in EMP table. Then the next question is to find out the maximum salary. So max is the function we have used to find out the maximum salary. Similarly, you can use min function to find out minimum salary. So here you can check 5000 is the maximum salary, as we have found out it is for king, who is the president. And as I was telling about mean, so this is the way to find out the minimum salary. So min function is used to find out minimum salary. The next question is, find the sum of the salaries of clerks in the employees table. We want to find out sum of the salary, but for the people, for the employees who are working as clerks. So here you can use where clause to find out sum of the salary for clerks. So same function, sum of sal from EMP. There is a condition, that's why we are using where clause, where job is equal to clerk. So it is going to find out sum of the salaries for all the clerks. So this is the way to find out sum of the salary for clerks. Next question we are going to solve. So select count. So as in the next question we want to find out the count, that's why we are using count of star. So select count of star from EMP, where job is equal to clerk. So we want to find out how many clerks are there. So we have used count function for that, and with where condition. So this is how you can find out number of clerks. So here you can check in the table, clerk 1, clerk 2, and clerk 3. So there are three people who are working as clerk in the department. Next question, display total number of unique job types. So how many unique jobs are there in that particular organization, which you can see in empty table. So you want to find out that. So again we are going to use a count function, but with a keyword called as distinct. So select distinct job from table emp. So it is going to give 5. So that means that there are 5 unique job types. So here you can check. There is a job called as salesman, then there is a job called as manager, then analyst, president and clerk. So total 5 jobs are there, the unique job types we have found. Next, display total number of characters in the longest employee name. We want to find out how many total number of characters are there in the longest employee name. So this is how you can find out. Select max of, and then we are going to use a function called as length. Length is going to calculate the length of that particular field. So length of ename and maximum of that. So we are going using max function. So 6 is the length of the maximum longest employee name. Next question, find out the sum of salaries of each department. Now we want to find out sum of the salary but department wise. So what is the sum of the salary for department 10, what is the sum of the salary for department 20 and 30 respectively. So how to find out that? This is the way. Select department number comma sum of sal from emp, and we use group by clause. So group by department number. So this is how you can find out sum of the salary department wise. Next, display department number and sum of salary for those departments where sum of salaries of those departments is greater than 8500. So this query is going to show us how to use having clause. As we know when to use having clause, we can use having clause if the condition is based on aggregate functions. For example, if average of salary, there is a condition on that, there is a condition. If sum of salary, there is a condition on sum of salary, then only we use having clause. So whenever condition is based on aggregate functions like sum, minimum, max, average, count, then only we use having clause. So this query is going to show you sum of the salaries of all those departments where average salary, sum of the salary is greater than 8500. But in this case, we are going to see all. If we change it like this, sum of salary greater than 9000, then we are able to see only 2 rows. So this is how you can use having clause. That is also very important. So you can make a change in this particular question and make it as greater than 9000, sum of salary greater than 9000. Next question, display department number and total strength of salesman in that department where strength exceeds 1. It means we want to find out the department number and how many employees are working in that department as a salesman, and in whatever the department, if there are more than one salesman, display that. So to find out that particular thing, you can use this query. Select department number comma count of star means all from emp, where for which job you want to find out, you want to find out for salesman. So where job is equal to salesman. And what is another condition? They are saying that we should display department number for those department numbers where there are more than one salesman working. So group by department number and having count of that particular star greater than 1. That means strength exceeds 1. That means if there is more than one salesman, if there are more than one salesman working in that department, then display that. And that's why having count of star greater than 1. And order by 2. 2 means, 2 means the second column, that is count star, this one. So it is going to order it by number of salesmen in that department. So department 30 is having 4 people who are working as salesman. So here you can check in department 30. So first your salesman is working in department 30, second salesman working in department 30, third salesman again 30, and fourth salesman again 30. So yes, it is right. So this is how you can find out number of salesmen working in particular department. And in the last query, display maximum salary paid in each department. So find out the maximum salary according to each department. So to find out that, again we are going to use max function and we are going to use group by clause here. So select department number comma max of sal, and then we will have to group it by department number. So it's very simple to find out the maximum salary. So let us check the result. Select department number comma max of sal from emp, group by department number. So this is the maximum salary in each department. So this is how you can run aggregate functions. I am going to provide the file in the description below this video. So you can download this file I am talking about. So you will get it in the description. So that's it, friends. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching.